Another overanalyzed, overhyped, and overcomplicated training variable is rest times. Most experts believe you should keep rest periods short in order to provide an anabolic environment while achieving a massive pump. The amount of time we spend resting in between sets was once thought to be a very important factor for building muscle mass, particularly due to acute spikes in growth hormone when rest intervals are kept short. These days, however, we've got vast amounts of compelling evidence that suggests otherwise. Hormonal responses do still result from shorter rest periods, but those short bursts of growth hormone aren't responsible for more muscle growth. In fact, even if you were to inject supraphysiological amounts of growth hormone, you'd still experience no significant changes in muscle mass. This is to say that chasing acute increases in growth hormone by manipulating your rest intervals is, quite frankly, stupid. Let's consider a study published in the Journal of Strength and Conditioning Research where they compared the effects of different rest periods. One group rested for 1 minute in between sets, while the other group rested for 2.5 minutes between sets. Researchers found that, despite a higher acute anabolic hormone response in the group who rested for just 1 minute, the group who rested for longer experienced greater muscle gains. Another more recent study compared 1 minute rest in between sets to 3 minute rest in between sets. After an 8 week training period, the long rest group gained significantly more strength and muscle mass than the short rest group. This isn't to say that there's anything inherently wrong with short rest intervals, however, if they're impairing your ability to perform, they can become a huge roadblock to your training. The point of rest periods is twofold. Number one, to ensure you're primed and ready for your next set, and two, to mitigate the amount of time you spend in the weight room. As long as you're resting just enough to ensure you're recovered and ready for your next set, without resting so long that you end up spending your entire day at the gym, you'll be all set. Although there isn't an exact time frame you should aim for, there are some basic guidelines I'd recommend. However, let me be very clear. I do not expect you to sit around with a stopwatch and time your rest periods. Instead, pay attention to your body and use your best judgment when deciding whether or not you're ready for your next set. Now, before we jump into those guidelines, let me first say that some exercises will require longer rest periods than others. Compound exercises that involve multiple joints are going to require far more rest time between sets than isolation exercises. For example, if you're bench pressing for sets of 8 reps, it could take a good 2 minutes before you're ready for your next set. If you attempted to perform another set on the bench press after just 1 minute of rest, it's not likely you'd be able to complete all 8 reps. Perform a biceps curl for the same 8 reps, however, and you likely won't need more than a minute to recover. To take it a step further, lower body compound lifts like squats and deadlifts are inherently more fatiguing than, say, a bench press or barbell row. So while it may take you 3 minutes to fully recover from a heavy set on the bench press, it could take up to 5 minutes to fully recover from an intense set of deadlifts. Rest period guidelines. When training at a high intensity, 1-6 reps for example, complete recovery may not occur for as long as 3-5 minutes or more. When training with a heavy load, I'd suggest resting a minimum of 3 minutes in between sets. If, for whatever reason, you still haven't recovered fully, feel free to take another few minutes to do so. Likewise, though, if you're recovered and ready to go in less time, feel free to do so. Remember, the goal is more volume, not less time. When training at a moderate intensity, say 6-12 reps, rest of about 1-2 minutes would be more appropriate. Although most muscle building programs don't focus too much on muscle endurance, there may be times when a higher rep range is prescribed. In this case, rest periods of 45-60 seconds should suffice. Another thing you must keep in mind is that we don't typically perform isolation exercises in the 1-6 rep range. But in the rare case that you are performing barbell curls for sets of 5, it's not likely you'll need a full 3 minutes of rest. Similarly, if you're squatting for 15 reps, chances are you'll need more than 60 seconds to fully recover. So again, these aren't hard and fast rules, they're simply a guideline you can use to ensure you're resting enough to maximize your performance in the gym. And since progressive overload, gradually increasing volume over time, is the main pathway by which we build muscle, performance should be your main focus. Time efficiency. If you're short on time, resting long enough to ensure you're fully recovered may not seem feasible. If that's the case, there are two training strategies I'd suggest that will allow you to cut down your workout time without impairing your performance or sacrificing volume. Number one, supersets. These are essentially just back-to-back exercises that target different muscle groups, for example, biceps and triceps, chest and back, and so on and so forth. The superset is executed by performing one set of a given exercise and then immediately following it up with an exercise that targets a different muscle. Let's take a bench press and a barbell row, for example. First, you'd perform one set on the bench press. From there, you transition into one set of barbell rows with minimal rest in between exercises. While you're performing the barbell row, your chest and triceps are recovering from the bench press. And while you're bench pressing, your back and biceps are recovering from the barbell rows, allowing you to perform the same or more volume in less time. Number two, rest pause sets. A study published in the Journal of Strength and Conditioning Research compared rest-pause training to traditional multi-set training. Not only did rest-pause training produce similar strength gains to traditional multi-set training, but the rest-pause method produced greater muscle gains as well. So rather than performing four sets of bicep curls with 1 to 2 minutes in between sets, for example, incorporate rest-pause sets in order to achieve the same or more volume in less time. To perform rest pause sets, take your set to the point of failure, release the weight, and rest 10 to 15 seconds. Using the same amount of weight, perform as many reps as possible. Rest 10 to 15 seconds, then knock out another set for as many reps as you can. To summarize, rest as long as you need in order to fully recover for your next set. If you're training really heavy, you'll typically need about 3 to 5 minutes of rest to fully recover. In a moderate rep range, however, 2 minutes in between sets for compound lifts and 1 minute in between sets for isolation exercises should suffice. Remember, the main purpose of rest times is to ensure we're prepared for our next set and to mitigate the amount of time we spend in the gym. If you're short on time, incorporate supersets or rest pause training to ensure you're getting enough total volume. Did you find this video helpful? If so, click the like button below as it'll truly help out the channel. Are you looking for a complete, done-for-you training and nutrition guide guaranteed to add slabs of muscle to your frame in the next 90 days? Claim your free copy of my book, Bulk Up Fast. The book has already been paid for. All you have to do is cover the small shipping fee. Just click the link in the description, tell me where to ship it, and I'll send it to you anywhere in the world. And if you haven't already, make sure you subscribe for more videos and don't forget to turn on post notifications so you don't miss the next one. Peace.